Pastor November and his girlfriend have just really become an insult to the church. But I have a verse that I want to read before we actually watch that video that they actually made very recently. That's 2 Peter chapter number 2. Speaks about they will secretly introduce, okay, heresies, even denying the Lord that saved them, bringing swift destruction to themselves. But this is the icing on the cake on this verse, speaking about what they do in the way that they handle themselves before the public. He says, and many will follow in their depravity because of them. Notice, it's because of them, because of the way that they handle themselves in the public, the way of truth will be defamed. So, which means people will speak evil of the way of truth, which is Christianity, because of the things that these people represent out in the public, how people get to see them and how people perceive the things that they do, and in everything that actually gets played out. At the end of the day, people will have a very negative view of the faith because of these people. It's the Actuality Show, the daily Christian commentary videos. If it's the first time over here, be sure check out the other videos that are down in the pinned comments. I'm going to check you out over there. Now, what is it that they were saying? They start off. We have a little bit of ground to play here. And that's him and his girlfriend.
I'm willing. I'm a Holy Cross Choir of Holy South Africa. What do you think of
So, fuck off. It's like, F you off. That's, so those who are going to look at this with the critical eye, they should.
Fuck off.
Fuck off, man.
Let Alan be built out today.
So, they say, she says, they should close their Bible and leave her alone. So they are speaking to people of they must go to all night prayers.
Sister J, Sister Jacqueline. Sister Jacobetta, Sister Jo. Guys, let's work a Friday to work a sex now.
Friday, they speak about sex.
I'm not too young, Billy.
Nicely. Shameful.
Billy, really? This time, sir, we're really back. We're really testimony.
So they come with testimony. So they go practice what then. Okay.
She
came with the exhibit. The shamefulness of this video. It's very. No ounce of shame on your parts. No, nothing. Just, yeah, they're just bragging about their. So they were questioning him on whether the things that he speaks about, he does them. So exhibit A, that he's been practicing it with her. And they're gonna give her time to give a testimony of how good he is. He's
I must come out from the toilet.
Closet.
People said he must come out of the closet. So, because he's been doing well with his girlfriend, it's not his wife, with his girlfriend in his bed, they must come and listen to him because they were saying he's in the closet because he dresses like a woman.
Look, I'm not going to say, this man is gay. He should come off the
come out of the closet.
Come, you come. Come to the closet. Come to the closet.
Ah, that's closet. Zan. Izan in the closet. Izan. Izan in the closet. Sinfuna la. Sinfuna la.
And then they go on and just think. Now, that's the most painful 6 minutes you might have had. Trust me, I will not put you through further that. Now, just for reference, you want to see this video, Church Hub uploaded the video. Okay, so you can go check it, but I'll leave it down in the pinned comment so you can go navigate if you want to see what he says. There is a level of shame that you just can't utter. It only speaks for itself. So, no conscience. Like, they don't have a conscience. They have zero conscience whatsoever. Now, isn't that exactly what Romans was warning about? That there is people that go into their lusts to a point where it becomes destructive. Romans chapter number 1, verse number 20. Now remember, it says, you know, they start becoming worshippers of creation and stuff like that and all that kind of stuff. It says, for this reason, God gave them up to dishonorable passions. There is a context in which we can speak about sex lifestyle for married people. And then there's this where people are doing their things to brag to the world while they claim to hold position in church. And they come out bragging about exhibit A. Like, there's a little bit of shame, Nyana. Like, you just a little bit if you have a conscience. But here, when one is given over to dishonorable, you know, remember that other Bible verse that says their pride is in their shame. Yeah, nah, it's ugly. Philippians chapter number 3, verse number 18. And it says, be careful, observe those who walk according to the pattern set for you. Right? He says, for as I have often told you before, now say again in tears. This is how painful it is to say this thing. I say this in tears. Many live as enemies of the cross, devout to passions. Even their laughter just annoys you. You know, Second Timothy chapter number 3, it says, but understand this, that in the last days, terrible times will come, for men will become lovers of themselves, lovers of money, boastful, arrogant. This is the thing that you see from their character. This is the thing that you have as a highlight. When a person loses that aspect of being, of having a bit of shame about doing something wrong, and bragging. All the, you know, you Christians, get away. And I'm gonna leave it there. We've said everything that needs to be said. May they do bring herbs, Sangoma's herbs in church, and they do what? False doctrine, ride into the church with bikes and do what and all that kind of stuff. It's all highlights that they were supposed to look at to say, oh, okay, this is what's happening. But now they have to deal. Now, and then he went like, you you have to have a little bit of shame, you know, just a little, you know, just as much as we ask for little faith from believers, you need a little bit of shame in order for you to be able to call yourself to order when you get out. Here there's none, like zero, zringe. There's nothing, no ounce of shame, nothing. Why? You've emboldened them in falsehood. I can't wish you well in whatever you guys do. The Bible forbids me from doing that. You know, it says, do not wish people like that. Godspeed. What we can say is that, hey, you asked for it, that's what you have. You shocked? You know, don't be shocked. There's nothing. Like if a person came to me and said, Pastor November deceived me, I would lash you down the wall. You were deceived into what? Like how were you deceived? Into what? Full of games.